What do you say? It's like Battlefield. What do you say that? Dude, Battlefield 1 was actually pretty cool.
Everybody, it's the coach. This is a special edition of the divisional round playoffs on E.
Yeah, World
okay,
War One.
Coach, thank you. We are about 4,300 we gotta get this miles next away from you there in Orlando as we come to you from the European home of the NFL.
That's ball game.
London,
shit.
England. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game
they
as
got
we've got a great one in
course.
Store. Between the
damn,
Dallas
South
Cowboys
whipped their ass tonight.
And the London Black Knights.
Yeah, 35-7. Taylor Hart's having a fucking party tonight.
A first down throw for Prescott.
Taylor Hart is
picked off near the 26. They're going to set up shot at the 27-yard line. Brandon, when we salvage the offensive coordinator and the head coach.
No, this dude's like,
what?
He's not in high school.
On first and 10, it's
he
Sanders.
Plays softball, boys.
And fights through one man. He's able to get six. And nice pick up down to the 21. On second down,
him and Beck could get along real
Sanders.
Well.
They'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Honestly, that would be a fucking awesome conversation.
And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. 8 yards, first down as they're able to convert. Had a chance to maybe limit them to three if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the ball. Everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defense just say, okay, new set of downs gives us another chance to make a play ourselves and maybe change things up.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
I'm an educator.
Who's going to win on first down? The offense or the defense?
I'm an educator. That's hurtful.
4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one. And it's caught. Touchdown. An 11-yard touchdown. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive.
Is he the fat one you sent me a picture of?
Better for them. They get the turnover. The football right away. Able to capitalize on all.
I thought you were going to say that's Will Richburg.
Game, right? The first points of a ball game. How about during the playoffs? Vitally important, and they've done that in this one. Five plays there on that drive. That's fielded in the end zone, and he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
A little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off and not the ha.
I don't think you pissed him off until I said the pills.
Can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. On third down, it's Prescott. That one completes Elliott. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. It's a gain of five.
Wow,
and that's
going to
make it fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down steps. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Give them 11 yards and time on the return. And the offense.
You guys said that about the shit talk, but then you see a picture of my nose and you're like, yep, that did it.
So here is the home side to take over on offense.
That shit fucking sucks, man.
Certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack.
And that's what I'm seeing so
hell
far.
Yeah.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10.
Good move.
They'll set up to throw. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
Drew, are you laughing or dying?
All week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, and have back on their heels.
Ooh. Try to get Mike Evans today.
Throw caught left side. So here's a first and
who's
10
got him?
At the 38.
Oh, yeah, Will, though.
His rebuttal was that I should trade Terry McLaurin for Sammy Watkins.
Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 like, yards and another first.
I like that one, partner.
Oh, you went from Evans to McLaurin for Watkins?
And really yeah. Shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's the best
yeah,
guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
Yeah, him and Jack are a little
on the pickup, and off that'll the wall, make it second it? Down. On second down, it's Sanders. And for a second straight play, that Cowboy defense.
I used to not like that Chris Fulmer guy until he sent me Julio Jones.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot.
He's not able to person to run
and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Who's that?
The Fulmer guy.
I need to hit him up.
Out of the gun now on third down.
Fucking before he asked for Cooks after well, last night's game, I was like,
there's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch in the playoffs. They'll block the throw, and he's got it. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. 10 yards, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. It's their quarterback.
Yep.
His second touchdown of this opening quarter. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
There you go, big.
He hit him earlier in this first quarter with his arm. Now he does it with his legs.
Right now, bitch. He's one of those stat stuffers that you see on the basketball court. You know, the guy with points, rebounds, assists,
wow.
Steals. One with the arm, one with the legs.
She said something.
Let's see if he can tend to this pace.
Dustin, I got one for you.
Out the reminder that, yeah, look. I'm known for she having said, an arm, but I can do it with
I was talking shit about she couldn't get this Dumb and Dumber reference. I said, really, you don't have a strong suit. And she goes, well, I'm pretty okay at cooking and I'm good at anal, so. Well.
Wow.
Maybe she meant to say avocado.
This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script
Jesus
plays. We know
Christ.
That, right? They have a script to
oh,
start the
damn,
ball
trying to feed that back.
And typically, those scripts go between 12 and 24,
get
25
these
plays.
Three.
How do you get that hockey game? Is it really that good?
Early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet. And try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything,
oh,
at
fuck.
Least 3 points, get that zero off the board. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another
oh,
first
shit.
And 10.
Wow. Technically, still got a shot if we get this one and then this one. Now, this is a normal thing.
Big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That's good.
All right,
for
now this one's a minus three.
And a first down.
Back get this one back
good
in.
Good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll try to sweep with Elliott.
Oh, what the fuck?
And
what
down,
in the actual
not
fuck?
Save the 25. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down.
My bad, I fucked
getting
it.
Getting the sense Charles are going to put a big emphasis on
I'm going to cover that shit up. Hell yeah, that's fine.
Why
that's
not?
Fine.
What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
That's fine, that's fine, that's fine. We get around this fucker.
Second and five down. Prescott, and they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Tight end has become a bigger and bigger part of the passing game in the NFL, but if you drop the football,
That position could get swapped out with a
yes, let's fucking go. Tie game, bitches. Tie game. They can go if you're not going to catch the ball.
And that's not just his first drop, his second drop.
No, this is And now the third down throw incomplete as well. That's fine.
He was waving his arms, wanted the football, but he dropped it. And that reminds me of the story you told me from your days at Tennessee. We don't need to mention the other guy's name, but when he dropped an open pass, you blew coverage.
Oh, fuck.
Really not right since I blew
coverage. Oh, my God.
I said, well, maybe next time he'll just walk it out here and hand it
to
you.
Oh, my God.
He wasn't real thrilled with that.
That's cold-blooded.
I mean, there was like fucking 0.9 seconds.
About a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Over 3?
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. After one, a 14-3 ball game. Second quarter now, and it's London with the football.
Who did?
As they've got it with a first and 10.
That's a weird fuck, man.
One on first down. Sanders. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A nice pickup there of 11
yards. He's real big into music now.
he likes music. What a fucking loser.
He sings.
But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that, because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down.
He's like, check this song out.
I'm
like, Dick, I've been listening to that. Like,
anytime you call an inside running play,
are you saying you like a Spotify playlist or something?
There. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
This is Miller, complete. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Dude, did you hear this new Little Wayne?
Now back to throw. He's got a man. It's Williams. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys.
Apparently, Little Wayne, or Birdman, is Little Wayne's uncle.
First down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. Looking to throw.
It's in that, sir. Have you heard this song?
Everything off. It brings up third.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on
how the fuck are you making me listen to this?
Need to come up with something here on third down.
God damn it.
It'll be tipped and intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long. But you can bet this defense knows that as well. So they've got him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Should have got 3 years.
Say what? A slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points.
Oh, wow.
And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Ja'Kai Polite gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here at 2nd and 15. They'll try the right side with Elliott. And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15. Give him 9 there. They still need 6 more now on third down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
God damn.
And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. In the wild card win last week, he had just 2 catches, and now he's got his first one here. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows who the ball is before the defender does.
Oh, shit. That's going in.
That one 28 yards.
Golly. A tough fuck that shit.
Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs, because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
And he's going to be...
Should I spend $60 and download this game right now? Well, $59.99, so technically not. Delete every game off from Dumb Planet.
Down inside the 20 at the 15.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I'll be get much more balance than this.
Oh,
big
time
run,
it.
Big
I
time
was,
pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can
fuck me.
Take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
Yep, by yourself.
A 15.
Well, I'll catch you guys later.
Touchdown grab as his guys are back within a single score. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
The lead cut to just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go, Forrest,
so here is the home side to take over on offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Second and 10. And caught by Henry. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. 23 yards the pickup there. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield. Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
They're going for a receiver there. Already has one touchdown in this first half. A second one not to be.
I like where their headspace is, though. I mean, I really like the thought process, right? You got a guy who's already scored one, right? You want to go back to him, continue the hot hand, and make them adjust to you defensively. I like what they were trying to get done, even though they weren't successful.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And it's complete. Henry. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 20-yard line. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Walker.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Yannick Ngakoue just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. They'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Now Prescott. Oh, he's got a little daylight.
Brandon, they didn't get everything.
And this results in 6. Touchdown. Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have 5 defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Dak Prescott on the offense heading back onto the field. Looking to pick up some steam, generate some steam right now. Down on the scoreboard and struggling a bit.
And sometimes you have to find it from places you don't ordinarily get it. Not necessarily just going back and throwing the football. Maybe use your legs a little bit. Maybe you rely on some teammates, get the ball in their hands. Anything to try and generate a spark. The bottom line, he has to play a lot better.
Yeah, he does. He's got the 2 INTs and the 1 touchdown pass so far. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Prescott now 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Prescott from the gun. And that's Elliott, complete. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make this a second down. Prescott urging his guys to go quickly. They need to get up and set. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. The tight end Cameron Brate was the target, and it's third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Prescott on first down. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. And again, it's Prescott. And break, the tight end's got it. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Final play of the half, Prescott. And that will be incomplete. So we've come upon halftime. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And all the way down to the 35. And he's going to get this all the way down to the Cowboys' 35-yard line.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Cheetah Bay Awuzie with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They start on the ground with Elliott. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. To throw is Prescott. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That catch good for 5. It's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. That one complete to Elliott. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. They'll get a couple yards on that one. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Rolling to his left, he completes it to Henry. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 43. He'll drop to throw. Dancing to his left. And the ball is knocked out. It's picked up by the Cowboys.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football?
Well, it should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you've got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Hey, come on now, come on now. What do you think?
On second and 7, Prescott, the quick slant caught. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. One man in the backfield. That's Elliott on second and goal. Throwing. Prescott. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. So now, fourth and goal. You're trailing by a decent amount here. What are you doing, Coach Davis?
Well, I've got to think to myself, just how many more opportunities am I going to have this close and have this chance? I've got to go for it right here. The clock's dwindling on me. Let's go get it done.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post. Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
A running play here on first down is going to go nowhere as he is tackled behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll lead here to a third down.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. They'll look to throw here. And that is incomplete.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9. They're going to try and throw. The catch made by Miller. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. Back to throw now on first down. Complete. It's Henry. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. This quarterback now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. Here's a quick hitch route, and the throw complete. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Second and six. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. 1 quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On play action, they'll throw. Forced out to his left. And that is caught. But he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete. So the ref takes a peek here, wants to see if the receiver... Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually...
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. DeMarcus Lawrence giving him once again his third sack of the afternoon. He'll look to throw, buying time to his left. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down. Back to throw. That is an absolute backbreaker. That was a designed passing play, wasn't a draw. You think you got him stopped, good coverage downfield, and he's able to pick up the first with his legs defensively. That kicks into your psyche and hurts a little bit, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and here's the thing. Anytime you give up a first down, it hurts you psychologically, but it hurts more when they get it this way because you've covered everything. He didn't have any place to throw the football. He takes off running and picks it up anyway.
And it's caught. Touchdown. Scott Miller there to make the grab. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super...
would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Fire, beware. That's fielded in the end zone. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devin White leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of six. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Here's Prescott. And Boyd has it over the middle. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the defense will get their hands on it. Going the other way. And the return will stop right around the 25.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget. Absolutely. Now a play fake here on first down. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line.
You got it. You got it. You got it.
That's a gain of seven.
Okay, ready?
Third and three.
It's been a long day for you.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Then caught by Henry. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Back to throw here. And it's caught. Touchdown. Mike Evans there to make the grab. And his guys capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devin White picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Prescott down. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stack sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now sack. Well, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
Devin White able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
A good return there, 17 yards. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over for the first and 10 on the short side of the field. On first down. It's Sanders, and that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Call it a loss of six on the play, and it'll be a second and long.
Watch the slip. Ready.
Another run with Sanders, and nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. And now they're in the hurry up.
54, right there. 54, Mike.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And it's complete. Henry. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And he'll get this one down to about the 27.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. So we got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. They follow up the first down one-yard run with a minimal gain of two. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Prescott from the gun. And break, the tight end's got it. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 15 yards on the play, first down. A first down throw for Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devin White, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. The Cowboys on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is third and 7. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense is well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
So here is the home side to take over on offense. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on three games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And
that's caught at the 25. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
The extra point up and good, but this one was decided anyway, as that will be the final action in this ball game. And they have secured a spot in the conference championship, and now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say cheerio from London.
Skills. Yeah, how about it? How about it? You want it too heavy? You got it. Go snatch it. driving your projects. Pain driven, itching, drumming. Hey, look how far we coming. Sweet for the streets, you can do it. Ain't real for the weekend. Sweet, this sugar. One man on me, but get deep. Watch what you doing. I ain't damaged goods, damn out the clay. You wish you could. I do this for the family. I might just blow my wheel. I'm giving it so for real. Who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving they soul the chills. My journey cold is chill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah. They first off the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way right before the deal. Say this one for your photo reel. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills.
Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team.
They react and play it back on the camera. Hot boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Heat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. I do weekly what you do on the annual. MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle us. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed we emerging victorious. Years blessed, sweat, tears is glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us.
Dash, got it on, smash. Foot on the gas, I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me, celebrate, I'm cocky. I do my dance, jump in the stands. No man, no man, I'll deal with the hands. Thought they could guard me, I ruin their plans. I do what I want, they do what they can. All right, coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, at Heinz Field. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Yellow, there's a lot of 80. Get that ball, Dean. Let's get that ball.
They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
It's coming,
They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. And he's got the first, but we also have a flag on the field. And they're already walking backwards. He was trying to clear the way, the big fullback. Instead, he gets a hold.
And you don't see that very often on running plays from those guys because usually they're the lead blocker. Normally, when he gets caught, it's in a passing situation.
And he checks this one down to Williams. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage. 17 on the play. Mahomes now on first down. Blitz coming and down he goes.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And yeah, just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
23 yards the pickup there.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Give them a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devin Bush able to record his fifth sack of the season. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback, because when he's not being hit, as you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the seven they wanted, but they'll take the three.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they had three first downs and 3 points. Here's Ramirez, throwing on first down. Got an open man, it's Washington. And he'll get this one way up, just shy of the 45-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And it's complete. He gets this one to Washington. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That's good for 28 yards. On first down, Ramirez. That's caught by Penny. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. Second and two. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. James Washington, his second touchdown on the season. And the Steelers have taken the lead. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. But I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's
right.
High
that's
mark.
The highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
And now here comes Kansas City. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gassed,
yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Williams. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. On the ground, this is Williams. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. And it's complete to Kelce. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. First catch on that one for Kelce, and it's a first down. Mahomes will bring him up first and 10. And he's a perfect 5 for 5 here to begin the game. Now Mahomes. That's complete to Williams out of the backfield. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got a bike. Uh-oh.
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
That's 3 sacks now. That's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again. On second and goal, Mahomes will set up the screen. This is Williams. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. They need to reverse the trend. The last 2 plays have gone backwards. Now it's 3rd and goal. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. They need to reverse the trend. The last 2 plays have gone backwards. Now it's 3rd and goal. Throwing now is Mahomes. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Watkins, the intended receiver.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Ramirez now from the gun, he'll throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Have a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, 2nd down.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They'll get 19 out of this, but it will still bring up a 4th down.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big game. And he fires one that's intercepted.
picked off at the 35. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react.
Down the numbers. There he goes. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are going to jump back in front. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go.
James Washington making his way back out towards the huddle. A September sure treated him kindly. Now we flip over to October. Any reason to think that those numbers drop, or can he keep the pace up?
Well, he can keep the pace up, but it's going to get a lot more difficult now. To me, it's a lot like baseball. All right? When they first hit the league, whether it's a pitcher or a hitter, and they go through the league the first.
And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. James Washington, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Steelers have once again taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you keep Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. And the pressure gets to him again. T.J. Watt able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Mahomes hit. He lost the football. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way. Just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
James Washington making his way back out towards the huddle. He might be on his way to a record-setting performance. So good here. We're only in the second quarter.
And it's so interesting when we watch these types of days unfold for a receiver, because they need a quarterback throwing it accurately, people to block for the quarterback, so many other variables. But boy, he's getting it done, and in a big way. Right now, he wants to rock on every snap.
Yeah, he's counting his yards in the hundreds, not the tens. To throw is Ramirez on first down. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Definitely worth taking another deep shot here. He's already found the end zone twice here in the first half.
Yeah, go back to that same well. They've had trouble containing him, but able to contain him on that play. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there.
What a catch, and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. The head coach relied on his eagle eye in the sky to make the right call and was told to challenge it, and it looks like it's paid off.
And from a coach's standpoint, when you throw that flag, it's probably a pretty tense moment. Here it pays off.
Yeah, you have that little bit of indecision. You throw it where you feel like you're right, and then you think, uh-oh, did I get it right? In this case, they can celebrate.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs offense. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get him back into the ball game or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. Now a run on first down is not going to get off the ground as they will get him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of three. Now on second and 13. Mahomes to Thompson on the screen. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 16 yards, a first down.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Give him 7 yards on the carry, and it will take us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Mahomes now on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now here's Mahomes. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And now another one thrown incomplete. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, this phase is not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
Now Ramirez on first and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
So the ref makes a call. No touchdown there. Wipe it off the board. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Ramirez to throw again. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And that takes us from second to third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and ten. Here's Ramirez operating from the gun. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Here's Jordan Berry now as he'll punt it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance, if they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes his forward for about six. So on the big tight end, Holden.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And obviously not fooling anybody here as they stop him behind the line of scrimmage. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts, as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. The Chiefs on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is going to be third and 13. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. Avoids him at the 40. So a change of possession here on the punt. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
Mike, number 53.
On first and 10, Ramirez. Complete to Washington. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. A good pick up there, 26 yards. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And he takes it the distance. No time remaining.
No cloth on the field.
Yeah, no flags. And it's a kickoff return to end the first half. Such an electric play, so much fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's team.
We now proceed to the start of the second half. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This is taken at the 3. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing.
Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changeups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Ramirez now to throw on third down. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. So stop here defensively to start this third quarter. Just what's needed in a tie ball game.
Yeah, good chance to build back some momentum on the defensive side of the ball. In fact, what they've done is give their offense a nice push in the back as they get ready to take the field.
A big kick, 50 yards that time. With a return. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much
under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Devin Bush, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. He is proving his worth defensively, getting the sack here. That comes after being named the AFC Defensive Player of the Week for his performance in last week's game.
He's stacking games together, isn't he? I mean, you just mentioned what he did the previous week to be named AFC Defensive Player of the Week. Continuing to play at that level. And when you get that kind of confidence going, those kind of guys are hard to stop.
Looking to throw is Mahomes. Now they go screen. It's complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They do get 5 there, but it's not enough. And it'll be 4th down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Eluding the pressure right. Frank Clark able to drop him that time for his 2nd sack of the evening.
And that's his 2nd sack of the game. But this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long.
Mike, crunch time, defense. 53.
Now this time he'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. 3rd and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the 1st down. Defensive backs.
And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And he's going to bowl his way into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Damian Williams, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, as his guys are able to regain the lead. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run, end result, 6 points.
Touchdown. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Rashad Penny, and that'll bring up second down.
Appeared to me he was just trying to find an open receiver and got forced out to his right. Had to come off of a guy downfield, tried to hit his back, unable to connect. Should have been an easier throw moving to his right, though.
Yeah, much easier, obviously, for the right-handed quarterback. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown from 19 yards away as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. It's been quite the game for him individually. A trio of touchdown catches now.
So pick a route, any route. Whatever you want him to run, he's going to do it and do it well and end up in the end zone. This has really been fun to watch.
Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Damian Williams and the Chiefs ready to begin their next drive. He's toppled the century mark already, receiving the football, closing in on that on the ground, too. They've really had trouble handling him.
I think from what we've seen in this game, his success through the air has started to open things up for him on the ground, because now he's loosened up the defense, right? They've got to play just about every snap as if another receiver can get downfield on them, and he's been that receiver. Now they bring him back to the backfield. I think his yardage running the ball will increase as this one goes on.
Well, they might need to devote some extra attention to him, something just to stop the momentum he has. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Here's Mahomes to throw. Got his man. It's Williams. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end. But running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Fielded just inside the 20. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. James Washington making his way back out towards the huddle. A monster game so far, third quarter. He is lighting up the stat sheet.
And so many times when you see these types of games,
And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Like a freight train there, Derek Nnadi with a sack. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. He's going to fire one deep left sideline, and that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sack.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
How much were they, a dime? What were they?
15 cents.
51 yards on the punt there. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Here's Damian Williams making his way back out. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the one touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone. And now he's just trying to do it for a second time. And of course, with that comes additional yardage.
Yeah, looking for additional yardage. And again, that second score here in the third quarter. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. Mahomes now 13 out of 17 throwing the ball. He's got a first down. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first.
And a first down, Chiefs.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Back now in Pittsburgh. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Back now in Pittsburgh. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Mahomes going to throw. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Mahomes now to throw. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal. Second and goal from the 1. They'll run it with Williams. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play. Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes.
He's NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's 2 more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot 1 and 2 in that sack category. Butker's kick here is good, and they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it, happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
Well, we had a number of good games in the afternoon sessions, but this Sunday nighter might top them all. We come up here on 1st and 10. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Now this throw complete to Washington. The 30! And all the way down to the 22-yard line. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 41 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. Looking to throw. Ramirez. Complete. It's Henry. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Back to throw. Ramirez to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
When you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
That's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. Here's a 2nd and 7. The quick slant caught, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. It's their quarterback keeping it himself from a yard out as they have taken the lead. And maybe the defense caught a little by surprise there that he took off and got in.
Yeah, I would think so, because if you're analyzing it from that side of the ball, you're thinking running back, fullback. It takes you a while before you get to the quarterback.
Extra point right down the middle, and that will make this a 4-point game. That'll be taken in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
That'll be a pickup of 4 as they work with this 4-point fourth quarter lead.
throwing again on second down. Mahomes. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Well, there have been a ton of sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
Not at all. So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
To throw, it's Mahomes. He's got it to Williams. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a third down. Now the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling can lead to no yards gained.
They were trying to erase that deficit in one play.
They certainly were, but how about the reaction time and the instincts back deep to force the incompletion? We might need to mark this one down. We may look back and say, that was a game-saving play.
So possession goes over here on the punt. James Washington making his way back out towards the huddle. So far, he has the trio of touchdowns. Obviously, it's been a pretty good game for him.
So if this were hockey, they'd be throwing their hats out on the ice for the hat trick, right? I'm not sure exactly what you do in the NFL except applaud and continue to hope you see a little bit more of this. What a tremendous game.
Do you want to start a new tradition? What can we throw on the field?
I don't know.
Throw your mic out there.
A lot of fans would like that. Cut his mic off.
Three touchdowns so far. Here's second and eight. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. Probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about four. That's a gain of four here in the fourth quarter with them leading by four on the scoreboard. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Steelers with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They'll try and run for it with Kenny. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now Rashad Penny. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Come on, baby. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. They'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Looking to throw, Ramirez. Second and goal, and Penny standing by himself in the backfield. That one looks like he'll throw here. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes Mahomes and the Chiefs, down by 11, 43 seconds to go. And they're in danger of a third straight loss. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Devin Bush in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. To try again after the sack. Mahomes, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. picked by Kendall Fuller.
Not that time for Watkins.
To throw is Ramirez. Throwing on first down. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. From 21 yards away. And the Steelers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that's leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Pittsburgh, their strong September has carried over to October as they move to 5-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for the Chiefs, they drop below 500 to 2-3 with a loss. And perhaps fortunately for them, they'll get an early bye next week and come back to action in Week 7. Thanks for tuning in, everybody, alongside Charles.
Bro. Remember what we were just talking about turning a guy into a superstar X Factor? Just got it. It just came up. He said, hey, I want to, like, he did the same star thing. And I was like, because it was my linebacker, Bush. I was like, the motherfucker's already a superstar. And then, like, it came up with, like, what to do. And it was like, get, like, 3 tackles for losses and 3 sacks. And I was like, holy fuck. This motherfucker's about to be a superstar X Factor. I think it has something to do. I think it has something to do with winning Player of the Week, because it was after he had Player of the Week. I know. I don't think it's every time. I don't know. I don't know. Because I think every guy that I've had it has been like had a big week, you know. I don't know, but you're right. I don't know what the fucking formula to that is. I'm about to see what this shit is. View message, breakout player. Coach, I did everything I could out there, and I hope I set a new standard for the team after today. Those guys know it's my defense. Devin Bush is now a superstar X Factor, and he can use zone ability. Fuck yes.
Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team.
Dope. I don't even think what's his face is a reinforcement. This game's top defender excel in situations. When they enter the zone, the ability increases their chance of defeating run blocks, tackling, and disrupting catches. My linebacker is a pick artist. How crazy is that? Like, I needed that.
Yeah,
Yeah, I know. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. Like, yeah. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. I don't know. I don't fucking understand it. Like, so he got Superstar X Factor, right? I don't think Devin White's a Superstar X Factor, and I've won like 3 Defensive Player of the Years with him. Like, so that's shit confusing. Okay, take my Bears team. Roquan Smith won Defensive Player of the Year, had insane stats. Leonard, whatever the fuck his name is, what is a superstar now. Like, what the fuck? Now you can't unlock that shit. They did that whole, you have to be a 90 to unlock the second thing or whatever. I had a guy that was 80 superstar and that had it, and I was like, what the fuck? What the fuck's Creek at, man? I advanced both leagues. I advance both leagues.
Cross the globe. I guess the road is my home, and there's so many mil, 'cause bird in my dome and like turbulent air. switching these flows. If you lick on my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell as a vessel alone. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes. They do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jobs. I'm not a guard. The heart with a squad. I'm playing my part. I'm LeBron.
Oh, yeah. So I've been getting that. I've been getting my old O-line dude keeps asking about what I want to improve with my rookie O-line dude, and I keep getting like points for it. Shit, I'm about to sign a fucking old ass veteran right now. I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the top. Take a higher that's a god. Man, on my heart. No, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take a higher that's a god. Never stopping as a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS another loss. GPS another loss. Who do it better than me? Yeah. Vision on 2020. Yeah. BBS Club of D. Yeah. Determination, laser focus, banging on they door, they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus, banging on they. And there's no old motherfuckers on the fucking free agent list. Can I trade for an old dude? Oh, you're running back? Honestly, you know what sucks? When he gets injured. I don't care. Get that breakout, bro. This might be my favorite team I've ever had. My quarterback is perfect. He scrambles. He's got a cannon. Sure, he's a superstar, though. He will be when he wins MVP this year. What the fuck are you watching? You're acting like I don't cheese it the fuck up. I pretty much did one play that entire game to get him his sacks. Say less, homie. Nah, it's kinda looking like shit. Yeah, but move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains. Huh? Yeah, I haven't really seen anything. Holy shit. Yeah, that's out. I haven't really looked. No, it's not bad at all. I don't think it's bad. Yeah, good God, turn the sun off. Can my punter be my kicker too? Does he actually kick good? Find out. I did like wheel routes, and then like if I got a pick or if I got a breakaway play, I just run out of bounds at the one. The Tariq Cohen shit. Oh, what is that noise? God, it's horrible. Fuck. No, not you. Oh, God. Put my headset all the way on for that shit. Pass the fuck out. Yeah, she sucks. Piece of shit, and I'm reporting you. I gotta do what I gotta do. How do you think I get 100 sacks fucking a season? How is Thomas Davis even still alive?
My game too cold, made it shiver, but I'm still a hot cool down, let it simmer. Hey, see
Well, and me can just give a shit ton up to the fucking Saints. Or the Chiefs. They got rid of Dak. I think it's a rookie. Hale, maybe? It's weird how I remember that. Defense, points allowed. Yeah, you're beating the Broncos by 4. Oh, God. Creek's second to last. Creek's second to last in points per game, too. Obviously, we know who for. Try to get another pick? Like you can only tank, so I've never tanked in my life. I'd be pissed. Yeah, I just would have quit the league. I tried to do that, it doesn't work. Damn, you haven't won player of the week? What a loser. Loser? MVP's a wrap, bro. Huh? I'm a team player. You know what happens if you see me at the Super Bowl, let's be real. Alright, I'm going to bed. I gotta get up early and do this fucking coffee date bullshit. Yeah, because that's what I fucking said. Said I hate you. Hopefully someone plays some fucking games. I know, dude, I'm serious, I'm just gonna fucking sim it. And by sim, I mean W for me, cause I've been trying. Okay, we have witnesses for that. We still out, gonna be another couple hours, I'll hit you up tomorrow. That's the message I just got from him. I literally just sent, at this rate I'm taking a sim, this is ridiculous. He just said it's gonna be another couple of hours. West Coast is not a fucking excuse. And we always cater to that fucking shit. Yeah, I want him to get up at fucking 6 to play one for us. Damn, I don't want to get up that early. call his bluff. What if he says yeah? Damn, I got a nice new fucking coffee maker. Hell yeah. I got a cold brew coffee maker. Fuck Starbucks. I wasn't really a coffee drinker until I had to get up before mid-afternoon. Now I have to. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Let it rip.